So at 10 is the alien from Annihilation, which you've seen, right?
Oh, yeah. I think I fell asleep, so I need to watch it again.
The bit at the end where the alien rocks
up. I wasn't well when I watched it.
It's the bit at the end where the alien rocks up and he's like...
Yeah, I don't think I saw it.
It's all really weird.
It's a good film, that.
It's a very good film. My number 9 is Before the Flood by Trent Reznor and Ashley Ross from I forgot the name of the film. Yeah, it's called Before the Flood, sorry.
Yeah, well, I remember, I think... From hearing about it to watching it was a day for me. I was on Instagram, saw Leonardo DiCaprio, said, oh, it's live now, whatever.
It's on YouTube for free, wasn't it?
Didn't know anything about it, pre-production or anything.
Yep.
It was done, watched it. Life.
Yeah, but yeah, exactly. It's just mint, right?
Yeah.
It's fucking quality.
Very, very well good.
It's like 4 or 5 people in it. And do you know how they did it? That score. It's Trent Reznor, Atticus Ross, Gustavo Santaolalla, I think he's called, the Spanish guitarist, and then the...
Was he the guy who did the Daft Punk Get Lucky?
No. You're thinking of...
In different genres, by different guitarists.
Oh, it might be, actually. I'll Google it. It might be.
Long hair guy, looks like he's an Airborne.
We'll find out afterwards and then refer back to it. It might be. And then there's the Welsh band Mogwai. So there's three parties working on this, right?
Fair enough.
They all knew they had the score. So they'd work on things individually and send ideas, literally 1 second clips to each other, 20 second clips to each other, and go, oh, I like that, I'm going to feed onto it with this and whatever. I love that creative process.
An absolute, like, a melting pot of ideas.
Absolutely, absolutely. I've not put this in order, fuck it. Well, actually, no, I'll keep this order. I like this order. Right, okay.
I'm changing mine, I know I am.
So, that was number 9. Number 8, that's right, isn't it? So, number 10, The Alien. So shit are these. Number 10, The Alien from Annihilation. Number 9, Before the Flood from the film Before the Flood.
Yeah.
Number 8.
The Winter's Tale.
Yeah, The Winter's Tale. Someone Lived This from Blade Runner 2049. Yes, yeah.
Is that, which bit's that from again? When they go to...
When he goes to the Memory Maker place and she goes, she puts the thing up like the kids are having the happy birthday cake and stuff. And she's like, yes, these memories are real. Someone's had these memories and he thinks it was his and he thinks he was born. And he's like, fuck it. And he goes like, smashing shit
outside. The thing is with that score, it's not one I go to revisit and watch, but it was one that fit the film so well. Subtle.
Absolutely. And that's part of the reason what I've done with my top 10. I've not picked ones that I go out and listen to all the time. It's the ones that at that moment enhance the film.
Yeah. Same.
Which will explain the fuck out of my number 1 because you're probably not going to get it.
Okay.
Right.
Same with me actually as well.
It's
ones that fit the film and ones that have changed me.
Yes, perfect. Number 8. Number 7 is possibly one of the best endings of a film I've ever seen recently. Not recently, ages ago. And I watched it again on YouTube today to make sure it's still affecting me.
On
YouTube?
Okay, go on.
Somebody's put the YouTube bit of the film at the end on YouTube where the score starts and stuff. And it is Cloud Atlas finale from the film Cloud Atlas.
Okay.
Which is fucking amazing.
I need to watch that film.
Again, I'll just play 10 seconds of it for you. The guy who directed the film also wrote the theme song. Literally, read a few tunes, all of it.
Well, that's when you came up with that a while back. I was like, "That's my answer. That's what my answer is going to be when people ask me what I want to do."
Yeah.
Is what? What's he called? What is he playing?
Dennis Waterman, here to see you.
I want to be like him. Because people say, "What do you want to do?" I don't want to do one thing. I want to write a theme tune, sing the theme tune,
make it. Want to star in it, edit it, direct it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why not? It's like this for 8 minutes, mate.
So
fucking
who
quality.
Who did this then?
Tom Twyker, he's called.
Sounds like a wrestler.
He's done a couple of other films. He's done that one with that other Tom Hanks film where it's set in a desert and he's like a salesman or something. I've only seen it once. You might not have seen it.
Castaway?
No. It's in a desert, but it's not Castaway.
He's done shitloads of Tom Hanks. And he's a good lad. Me. If he was a dog, he'd be one of the best
you
dogs.
You need
going.
To watch the three...
That was a good analogy.
Very good analogy. He'd be a fucking old lab with a necktie on.
Yeah, with like impeccable everything.
Refined taste, has a cigar on, like full on... You need to watch the three Langdon films because the scores are amazing.
The three what?
Robert Langdon, his character.
The three lions.
No, Robert Langdon, you dick. Is the guy who
four
does
lions.
He does all the fucking like he studies like runes and old books and shit, and that's why he solves the puzzles for them three films. Okay, so that's 10, 8, 9, 10, so 6. Okay, my number 6 of top 10 scores at the moment from a certain film
movie
range.
Movie score tracks.
Movie score tracks. Yeah, the epilogue.
It's hypnotising for me.
The epilogue. It stops me dead every fucking time. And genuinely, when I was watching this, it kind of didn't hit me as well first time because I didn't know what was happening.
Yeah, because you were in it. You were.
I was so involved. I was like, "What the fuck's happening here?" But then I realised, shit, this is them imagining what lives they could have had with each other, and it was fucking.
Yeah, I didn't know that until you said that to me like a year later. Because I was just up for it. I don't care. Like, it made no sense.
Yeah, but
at the time,
it just worked as fuck. Yeah.
I was like, I'm that simple. You could play something that don't make sense, and I'm just like,
I'm gonna say now to you that I've done to six, so I've got five, yeah. Top five. My top five are all by different people. There you go, you see.
Mine, I can't remember mine, but mine might be.
I'm 10. Very intrigued to know yours, by the way.
I'm just gonna play my number 10 because
okay.
I didn't realise how much I liked this one until I rewatched
Until
I rewatched the thing that it's in and how much I was taken away by that moment.
Mm-hmm.
You ready? My number 10.
Oh, fuck me. Bob. Innit? That is amazing.
It's... Because at first, when I first listened to this song, I thought it was just this slow piano bit, but it gets the main Band of Brothers melody in at the end.
Is this like Suite 2 at the end of the thing, or...?
Winters on Subway.
Oh, in France. Oh, it fucking is, isn't it? It's where he has the bath, isn't it?
And he's looking at that kid.
Oh, my word.
How beautiful is it?
This is the bit where he gets his tezzies right in the water first, isn't it? Yeah. Woo! Yeah.
Yeah, tezzies. But it's only... I felt it's so... only 1:54, this, but when the main theme comes in, it makes me feel like everything's fine.
I know. I want to give him a hug in this scene when he's like walking around and he didn't know anyone and everyone's like that fuck banging into him and he's spark him out.
Yeah. You ready? So there's this little weird bit now. Michael Kamen, man, he's an absolute treasure. It's warm. When the main bit comes in, it's like someone putting their arm around you.
Fuck off. That's Lord of the Rings naughty, that, isn't it?
It is. There you go.
Did he do S&M?
First S&M, he
fucking
he was
did.
There.
I thought he did. He was conductor, wasn't he?
He was the one that Hetfield rang when he got the melody for Nothing Else Matters.
No shit.
He had hand on phone. Should we do S&M or should we collaborate at some point?
Should we do it and not call it S&M?
Other hand.
Like, yeah.
Ding 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 ding.
Holy
ding,
shit!
Because it's all open string, isn't it?
Yes, yeah. Fuck me. That's a good start.
Number 9, Portals.
So what was that called? What track was that called?
Winters on Subway.
Okay.
Number 9, Portals.
Yeah, fuck me. I'll give you a bit of a thing. This isn't in mine, and I realised as soon as we sat down that shit, I've not got Portals in mine.
That's an event. Avengers is one I never used to go to because I didn't know the specific ones that had the main theme. Every time I'd shuffle Avengers, it would always be the battle ones that are just
But was it Sylvester who did this one? I mean, with that, it's so fucking. I don't know how
he did Back to the Future as well, which I didn't know.
He's done a Harry Potter thing as well, hasn't he?
One or two, maybe. Yeah.
He is the pressure on that fucking man to get that 3 minutes right.
I'll play this.
You know what I mean?
22 years of or no, 22 years. 22 films.
22 films over 12 years, I think it was, wasn't it? Or longer than that. Oh yeah, but the point is,
it's the moment.
It's the highest grossing film ever, and it's the best bit of the highest grossing film ever that he had to no pressure, but fucking get it right. Yeah, unbelievable.
It's that violin's that little glimmer of hope in it.
And
it's the thing.
But when that starts to roar is when fucking Sam flies through it and it roars, that violin. Oh, this. Do you know why this is good?
Because it's. Do you think it's all over?
And that solo trumpet reminds you of Warship, doesn't it, right? It's Cap on his own.
Yeah. It's American Army, isn't it?
Fucking rocket it.
It's as loud as it goes on my phone. But yeah, exactly. I keep thinking of these moments. This song is so epic. Imagine just being on your laptop. Who would have had it on a project like this, recorded, played? I've done this.
The bit that makes me laugh, yes, how good that feels, but the bit that makes me laugh is when they originally screen this to like the 20 people have to say yes to then distribute it or whatever, and you start there going, and they're like, fuck.
Yeah.
This is where they're lining
up. Swear to God, if I.
They're all like doing this at this point, aren't they? Like, yeah, getting the punches ready and stuff. Yeah.
I reckon I could beat anyone. I could have Lesnar if someone put this on my headphones.
I've never drove with this on, but I bet it's good.
Yeah. Right.
Fucking hell.
I could play every song.
I think, yeah.
That was 9.
Yes.
Number 8, Duel of Fates. Purely because that just reminds me of being a young kid.
Yep.
And just pure anarchy and just...
Anarchy.
Yeah, and again, it's that rising to the... occasion.
How do you write this?
So yeah,
unbelievable.
That was 8.
Yes.
7.
Home.
Oh my word.
So I was stuck on the Dunkirk one, but this is from Dunkirk.
I thought Oil was better than Home, but Home hits me in a different place than Oil does.
Yeah, Oil's a great piece of Oil. Music, but this. Like you said, with all them old people going on the boats. Oh, guest, nearly got it to the second.
It's like a...
Yeah. It's like getting in the bath.
Yeah. It's subtle as well, though. It's not like, it's not like a Portals, we're fucking here! It's
alright, we're
here. It's like Britain's here though, isn't it? It's not like a fucking... It's not like the end of Star Wars where there's battleships rocking up.
It's home.
Familiarity's back. Yeah, exactly, yeah. I love that bit. It makes me happy, that fucking part of the film. Like I said, the only bit that makes me proud to be British, that whole film.
Yeah.
Like that fucking 3 minutes of that whole film. Or the whole film, really.
Last one of... Well, number 6 now.
Yes.
Lowercase.
Yep.
Stay.
That's the bit where he drives away, innit? Fuck me. I watched
Ignition
that.
Ignition 5.
Yeah. I watched that on YouTube the other day because they had the thing where they did the score live for the film.
Oh, with the screen on.
I forgot how sad that bit is where she's like, we could be the same age. And no, she's like, you don't know when you're coming back, do you?
Yeah. Oh, what'd she say? Something like, don't go. Or just something so simple like that.
Yeah. No, she translated the fucking Morse code and it says stay. It says stay there. And you're like, oh, fucking hell, mate. I remember that song because we watched this together in IMAX the first time, didn't we?
And they have the sound of like the rockets as well.
Ignition 5, yeah. Right. I remember when this happened. It's the next scene of the film is very quiet, and I just remember everyone in the cinema going, "Fuck me!" Because the aspect
you need that, don't you?
The aspect ratio changed as well. It goes from being non-IMAX to IMAX as soon as he starts the car.
Yeah.
So it's like that, and this like when they've done the equalizer on this, you can't hear anybody talking. It's just fucking Zimmer's 150% volume.
Yeah. He's like, this is my scene, pal.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is actually a wow, though.
And that's 6.
Unbelievable, Jeff.
So, back to you, sir. 5-3-2.
I think that's better than the other stay, because the other stay is just more the theme of the thing, isn't it? But that's the more emotional stay, I think, for me.